positive number next to 0, nobody can say what is the real number. Because if you say 0.00001, I can add another 0 in between 0 and 1. I can put so many zeros between 0 and 1, zeros, infinity of zeros I can put, but still I am not correct. Because another person will come and insert another 0. Another person will come and insert another 0. So infinity of people will come and insert infinity of zeros between 0 and 1. Therefore, nobody will be able to say what is the number next to 0. That is why B symbolizes the form of epsilon. Epsilon greater than 0, small, very small, positive quantity. Or positive real number, you can even say. Quantity, you can say. A small positive real number, that is the meaning of epsilon. Have you all got now? Have you ever thought about this way? No. So now you all understood what is the meaning of epsilon. Small positive number, because real numbers are uncountable, nobody cannot only pick the next to 0. Next to 1, can you say what is the real number? 1.1. 1.001, 1.000001, 1.000000000. Then another one more person will add 0. So we can't say what is the number next to any real number. Therefore, you cannot define. So we say it is uncountable. You have proof, right? You have a vigorous proof to say that real number is the real number is uncountable. But it is as simple as that. You cannot say. And also you understood the meaning of what is epsilon. A small positive quantity. It's a minimal positive quantity, but you cannot tell what it is. But that is still a number, real number next to 0. But you cannot define it. So people have defined it by the symbol epsilon. Similarly, delta, small positive quantity. Right? Next. I just want to tell you the application of mathematics in criminology. Cricket for number, now we are moving to criminology. That is a function conducted number 10. Thousands of people are attending them, attending the function. Each one will be given a, now just now you had one drink, right? Like that. That is a big thing, or drink is big. Not that way, not that way. It is put in all the glasses. Drink is poured into all the glasses, right? And the function is supposed to start. There comes a telephone call. So the person attends, the manager of the hotel attends it, saying that out of the 1,000 glasses with the drink, that is one glass with the poison. If anybody takes it, it's unfortunate person is going to die. So find out, for the party has to go on well, it should not be in with the tragic thing. So you have to find out. So people are, well, they're helpless, they don't know. What is the, I mean, the next step would be what? You call people from the laboratory. The laboratory technician will come and check each glass whether it contains poison or not. Suppose he uses some spoon or whatever it is into one glass, checks. Suppose it contains, doesn't contain, okay, he puts this other one. So how much time will it take to check all the 1,000? Then when to start the party? Here comes the mathematician to help. He's not a laboratory technician, but still he takes the help of one technician and finds, solves the problem in no time. No time, la ora half an hour kulla pandram chinda. Thousands of glasses. He is applying the partition technique. Partition technique, binary partition. Suppose you have 1,000 pota customer, 100 pota kama? 100. Suppose you have 100 glasses, 100 people are there. 1,000 pandal na tappala, but it's a lengthy explanation. Kunchi kumbhi kaka, I'm doing it for 100. 100 glasses are there. and it divides that into 50-50. Numbers set on one side, other 50 set on the other side. Then he takes a new tumbler, new glass, and he is asking to put spoon to each of the glasses. So 100 spoons are put into each of the glasses. Should not be mixed by mistake, one or the other, one or the other, twice or the other, twice or the other. So you should be very careful. Then he takes 150, he checks only with this 50. How he checks? He is not checking one by one. He takes one spoon of drink from each of the 15 glasses, put that into one glass, check for the poison. Testing, suppose all the 50 do not contain poison, this will be negative result. Poison is in one drop. Apri na nartho, this 50 has one tumbler as the poison. Okay, suppose it is found here. India vandu it has poison na. In the 50 glasses la edho or cup la poison
okay
va the problem. Then this is safe, it will have to poison. Then what do you do again? Ore or test pa panirukanga neer conductor one test test one la they found this is poisonous thing, but all the 50 didn't do it. From each glass he has taken one spoon of drink, put it into one glass. Adha check pannum bodhu nichu poison undha irukum illa. So he found out 25 50 irukku. Then it has been divided into two parts, 25 25. Again test two performed, second test. Eppadi 25 edho 25 eduthu andha 25 spoon vera glass eduthu adha podu.